Hey everyone, I'm Anupama.
And I'm Rahul Desai.
And we are here to talk about the only thing anyone is talking about, Padmaavat. Be warned, this is going to be a conversation. Rahul and I have of course seen the film and reviewed it. So we are going to be talking about scenes, talking about actors. If you haven't seen the film and you don't want spoilers, just don't come after us. Stop watching right now. Rahul? Good advice,
I guess. Though I'm pretty sure everyone's read so much about it by now. I think they are very aware of what happened in the film.
That's true.
When they probably watch it on screen, they'll be like, "Ye toh matlab, I think we've already seen this," and because of the drama behind the whole.
Disappointed admirer?
Yeah, disappointed, I'd say. It's been a while since I've actually liked a Bhansali film. But at the same time, I keep, whenever I go inside to watch a Bhansali film, I keep hoping that I'd be that teenager who was absolutely stunned by Black when I saw it, or was maybe a little blown away by Devdas when I saw it. Because I was, even that phase of my life back then, Bhansali was the filmmaker along with Ashutosh Govarikar at that time when we were growing up. So I keep looking for sparks, I don't know if it's how much to do with the fact that I've grown up and I've evolved with like my movie taste. I have no idea. I wish I had an answer to that. But it's been a while since I've been able to say that Bhansali film has satisfied me. And I was disappointed this time. I think most of us were though.
Yeah. I have to say that in with Bajirao, I was completely satisfied. I walked away feeling like I had just had a sumptuous meal and I had sort of, you know, I had wept and I had swooned and I had done everything that Bhansali was pressing the buttons on, you know. I mean, with Padmaavat, I didn't feel that. And I always feel, first of all, terrible when I critique his movies, because I know, I can see the work.
Yeah.
That's gone into each frame.
Exactly, that's
you know, I mean, just the rigor
and
his aesthetic sense, and there is so much to admire. And yet you can't get away from the truth that it doesn't hang together.
Exactly. I mean, even I, at some point when I'm writing a review or if I'm rating a Bhansali film, in my mind there's a switch that goes off saying, why are you rating this 2 or 2.5?
Right.
Because you just gave that indie film a week ago made on maybe like a couple of lakhs the same rating, but that's not how ratings work.
That's not how ratings
and work. That's not, I guess, how we should be working either.
Yeah.
So
you
have to be really objective about, I mean, a lot of people's careers are on the line. They work very hard for a Bhansali film, we know that.
Yeah.
But at the same time, if you put so much work into the technical aspect of the film, into your vision, the one thing Bhansali has lacked for like quite a long time has been like solid writing in general. So I think everyone has noticed that ever since he started making the period films, he's, and I noticed that ever since he started scoring the music for his own films, he has maybe started conceiving his films in his mind in a way where he can let the music sort of define the emotions of the film.
Right.
Because when you're a musician as well as a director, sometimes you tend to underestimate the writer in yourself.
Correct. So the music speaks.
Yeah, it, and he makes it speak a little too much.
The
then,
emotion,
you know?
And you don't need to.
And
have
you don't
emotion.
Need to have.
Yeah,
it,
yeah. Because for me in this movie, really the emotion came from the villain.
Yeah.
Khilji, I mean, it was completely.
It was his
The
film.
Bad man's movie.
Yeah, totally his film. Know? And I am traditionally not a big Ranveer Singh fan, but this film, I could see why people have loved him for so long, and I could see why you need a Ranveer Singh in a film or in this industry at this point, because he was given, I'd say he was given quite a free rein, as because when you're a villain, when you're like a villain in a film like this, and when you have to stand against the very purest form of good, you can absolutely go unhinged.
You can go crazy,
You can go crazy. I mean, it's a lot like all the famous villains over the years, that's their strength.
Yeah.
And I think Ranveer Singh did it well. He didn't have to concentrate too much on his dialect, his accent. Like in Bajirao, there were times when he'd just go off the rails slightly with his accent and all.
Yeah.
But here, you know, I think he was given a free rein, and that energy was, whenever he came on screen, I was like, very relieved in this film, because when the other two were on the screen, I was like, this is not the love story that will make me feel bad if a villain interrupts it. In fact, I want this to be terminated right now.
But you know, Rahul, I wonder how much that is a function of the writing, because truth is, you know, Shahid and Deepika are both fine actors.
Yeah, they have delivered
you know, some amazing performances. And I feel like because because this film was suddenly so much about Rajput valor and the greatness of Rajputs, that your characters inherently become cardboard because they can't express any human emotion.
Right.
You know, they're just walking sort of icons of piety and goodness and moral uprightness. And then where's the fun in that? You know, and then comes along this guy who's sort of just unhinged and at every level. I mean, he doesn't even eat properly.
I mean, my favorite parts were when he used to mock Shahid in the film, because that was exactly my emotion at that point of time. I was like, you guys are so obsessed with your Rajput valor and your thing to depict the Rajputs correctly, that you guys have totally lost the plot, because I'm looking at almost a propaganda film, you know. It makes me feel like, and that's not filmmaking, if you're, especially if you're Bhansali and you're trying to make something or recreate something from the past. That's just the wrong way to go about the film, and it's a tragedy, because, you know, there were obviously the Bhansali trademarks throughout the film. There were, but another thing which I absolutely disliked about the film is his choice to convert it into 3D. It absolutely nullified everything that Bhansali stands for, because, you know, when I watched the trailer, I really loved it, the trailer, and I was looking forward to the film because of the trailer. I saw the detail in the frames.
Right.
I'm like, wow, this is going to look great on the big screen.
Yeah.
When I went there, you're seeing a post-converted sort of 3D universe in which all the colors are sort of muted. He's trying very hard to sort of give different color coding to the villain's background and the heroes. And it felt so many parts just felt digital. And that's the worst thing you can do to a Bhansali. It's a tragedy.
Especially those long shots of Chittor.
Right.
And,
yeah,
know,
they felt very digital. The war scenes, some of
the
them.
The war scenes, yes. Yes,
and
absolutely.
When I have a feeling he may have done that to sort of compensate for all the drama that has preceded it, and to sort of sell his vision harder than he usually does. He didn't need to do that.
Yeah, and which is why my heart really goes out to him, because I don't know what was his original vision. What did
Nobody
he want?
Will know.
Yeah.
Nobody
what did he
know.
Want on that screen before all before all this hell broke loose?
Yeah.
You know, what was that point that he was trying to make? But in any case, in between all of these sort of digital landscapes and the two very pious, slightly cardboard characters, is this living, breathing madman who just, you know, makes that screen come alive.
Right.
And I've always been a Ranveer Singh admirer, Befik Ray, case in point.
Oh, yes. How can anyone forget?
How can you forget? The only human being on the planet who loved Befik Ray.
Yeah.
But I really thought here he completely let go as an actor. You know?
I wonder if it's because maybe midway through the film he must have realized, wow, this film isn't turning out how it should have been. I need to rev it up and sort of rescue this film. But I don't know, whatever he did, I'm glad that he was part of this film.
Yes.
Because without that, it would have been an absolutely awful experience.
Yeah, it would have been very hard. Despite, you know, listen, I'll have to admit, I'm a superficial type. I got through many scenes just checking out the clothes and the jewelry
picture,
and I was like, oh my god, I wonder where you get that outfit.
Yeah.
You know, I was having those thoughts when it just became so bloodless that
there
was nothing to be done.
Yeah.
You know, but Rahul, read out some choice comments you have.
Oh, for the review.
Yes. Wait, is somebody joining us? It's fine? Okay.
Right. Comment from Sumanta Sikdar. Have you ever liked something? You seem to be a master degree in pessimism. Show some respect to the epic vision. Not everyone can achieve the sheer spectacle.
Agreed.
That's
not
true.
Everyone
not
can.
Everyone
true.
Can. And
true.
He didn't. That's the whole point of the review, I guess. I mean, we
Do
live
you
in
have
an
a
age.
In pessimism.
Yeah, we live in an age where being realistic is called being pessimistic. So I don't know. Sometimes it's just the sort of industry we live in. If you have to call it out. I mean, I actually expected, I'm actually glad that, you know, a lot of critics looked at this film for what it was, because there was obviously an inclination to sort of support the film, the concept of the film in general, because of what it stood for
Which
in this country.
Do.
We do.
We do.
But that doesn't
mean
we support the vision of the film itself,
correct,
you know.
Correct.
In fact, like, I mean, we saw very well that it was an irony that they had to attack a film like this when they were pretty much...
They are the heroes.
They are the heroes, and they pretty much made
no
the
sense.
Film.
I just wonder if, you know, maybe some of them should just go watch the movie tonight. you know, it makes no sense.
Yeah, they'll feel ridiculous.
They should. Okay, let me read out my... of course, you can never win, right? So here is US DD Sharma who says, so Befikre is better with 3 stars, right?
I knew that was coming.
So, Mr. Sharma, in fact, it was 3.5 for Befikre. So let's get that right. And yes, so Rahul and I were talking about the star rating, okay? First of all, it's not in comparison to. It's whether that, and correct me if I'm wrong as far as I'm speaking for you here, Rahul, yeah. But I give that star rating. Does that film deliver on its promise?
Right, absolutely.
Okay, that's for me the star rating. So yeah. if it didn't deliver, it didn't deliver. And it doesn't matter if it's a better film or a worse film than another.
Yeah.
You know, so it's not, you're comparing apples and oranges.
Yeah, there is no comparison. You cannot compare star ratings. You cannot, I mean, it's actually, it's also sort of self-inflicted. The fact that we have to use stars, we have to face these questions all the time. It's going to keep happening. It's never going to change.
Yeah.
But that does not mean one film is better than the other. Maybe at just that point of time in the Hindi film industry, this film was probably as good as the star rating you gave it.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay,
read out another one.
Shlok Gupta, bunch of elite audience critics who are fan of Western cinema have no idea what kind of films people like in India. That's pretty much like a comment Rajiv is used to answering, I think. And I mean, this is the first time I've got this comment. But
really?
Yeah, I mean, theek hai, elite to I can understand.
Not only are you the what of pessimism?
Master's degree in pessimism.
Master's degree in pessimism, you're also elite.
Elite and
westernized. No, you appreciate Western cinema.
Yeah, I appreciate Western cinema way too much. Yeah, that's... yeah, well, there's no answer to this, obviously. I mean, you're elite. I mean, elite isn't a bad word here, so it's fine.
And what does that mean? That we speak in English?
Yeah, we speak in... of course, I'm also used to that criticism. Okay, big words, this, that. But
it's open. Let me read out. Choice on big words. Choice statement here. Deepak Mishra says, am I listening to Shashi Tharoor?
What?
Do you really use those words in your daily life? Which words, yeah, Deepak? I don't know. Like what? I mean, resplendent? Yeah, I wouldn't say resplendent in my daily life.
Exactly.
I don't know what else I used in that. I did end the review with a line from a poem, if that makes it
right. Difficult. I mean, I guess that's what he probably must have ticked him off, saying, does she speak like this in real life? But the whole point of reviews in general also is we don't always write them as in a language that we speak in real life. That's so not the point of writing.
Correct.
As writers, we sort of we have an opportunity to take time to express ourselves and put our words down on paper the way we would like to speak in real life. But we don't speak like that. That's the whole point of writing. So I guess even if they say, oh, fancy words, do you speak like that in real life? I'm like, no, I don't speak like that in real life, which is why I'm a writer here.
Yeah.
Like, that's the thing.
Thank you. Please, Deepak, note. What's something else you got?
I just wanted to read review of Padmaavati. It needn't have been a word-by-word comparison with another movie with lots of cynicism infused. Well, I did mention a few movies in the review, I have to admit. But then, yeah, I mean, word-by-word comparison, lots of cynicism. Not the first time I've been accused of cynicism. But this time I'd say, to my defense, I think I'm not the only one being cynical about the movie. If you read these reviews properly, I think a lot of people wanted to like the film.
Of course, we did.
And
I know I did. Yeah. I really wanted to like the film.
And I guess this just goes with my track record of not liking films. But the unfortunate part is this time I really wanted to like it. I expected things from it.
Sure.
And if I let down, I think I have a right to express that.
Absolutely. Yeah. And let me tell you guys, this man is the last one to be a cynic because he sees films that you could not pay me to see. Okay, and he seeks them out and goes into the far ends of the world to see it so he can tell you what he thinks about them. So he's not sinning. I got one that you would like. Faizan Kareem said, you have still been slightly generous in your review, Anupama. Desai killed it. Bhansali has become a slave to his obsession with beautiful frames over the last couple of films and storytelling has taken a backseat in almost all of them. Well, I suppose that's what we are saying.
Yeah, that I guess that's the consensus right now. And I also have a feeling that a lot of us weren't as cruel as we might have been if it was like a lesser filmmaker.
Sure.
We are maybe a little inclined towards favoring his vision. But
I am.
It, for me, it's also, he's sort of a last bastion of old school filmmaking in this industry, which keeps changing. And in my head, that keeps going on. And I was like, just don't make a bad film now, because don't do this. Because it's not only your filmmaking that's a problem. It's your storytelling and your attitude while making the, like, while telling that story, that's a problem. Because Johar itself, the concept of suicide or showing it in a film isn't a problem.
Right.
I used to remember the 90s films where if a bunch of guys in a contemporary landscape were running after a girl to assault her,
right,
and she came out blazing and committing suicide, that was a tragic scene. But
Correct.
The way he romanticized it here as a act of heroism, that's a problem. That's ticked everyone off.
But
and
now,
that's probably
isn't that the actual legend?
Yeah, that's the actual legend.
The legend glorifies it. So why blame him for glorifying it?
It's probably down to the way he's done it, you know.
Or is it down to his choice of this particular legend?
No, you could say that this is not the best time to be dabbling in this kind of storytelling. But I'm not a big believer of, you know, there's a right time or wrong time. I don't mind someone showing a rape on screen or showing controversial things on screen, because at that point in the 13th century, that was normal.
Right.
And that was there. And in fact, he's being authentic.
Yeah.
But it's the way he did it this time that might have gotten something out in most of. Because to be honest, while I was watching it, I was like, wow, this reminds me of the last scene of Devdas. He's done it with all the drama and it's taken 20 minutes to show women walking from year to year.
Correct.
And it sort of reminded me of my childhood, because I was watching that film and I was blown away by that last scene.
Right.
But then I came out, I was like, but what did I actually just see? Because he's actually just showing us something that a lot of us look down upon now. And to be honest, a lot of rural areas in India that are still grappling with this problem, if they see something like this, can you imagine what they'd think right now? Saying, ye toh hum sahi kar rahe hain.
Right.
So those things have to be taken into account in a big country like
this. Sort of a wider responsibility. I also have the same star issue. Really, 2.5. But you gave 3 to Kalakandi. Imagine. I seriously followed your reviews. This reach too exceeded your grasp. You are far too behind getting there. It's quite distorted. Dismayed. With this review, I'm going with 0.5 star.
With the review.
So, Damandeep Kaur has given me 0.5 star for my review, which is fine, Damandeep. I mean, really, like, you know, this is a gathering of, it's opinion, right? And I perfectly, you know, as I always say, let's agree to disagree. Are there any questions, anyone, or any last words, Rahul?
Nothing much, except like January didn't go as well as I wanted it to, because...
Mukabas was a happy experience.
Mukabas was a happy
experience. I like Kalakandi too. I know you didn't.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I won't say that I was totally disappointed, but it's nice that at least this film came out and, you know, we at least had a chance to watch it and stuff like that. But that said, you know, I just hope Bhansali's next film, he returns to a bit of, I mean, he returns, I don't know what he should return to, but he needs to really introspect on the kind of stories he needs to tell, because I think I'm pretty much done with his whole, you know, it. For me, it's like watching a superhero movie again and again and again, because they all start to look the same. I don't remember a scene from Ram Leela.
Yeah.
If they're all meshing in my brain for these three films, and that's the thing. I'd like to see Bhansali return to the Khamoshi days or even my favorite
is still
Hum Dil De Chuke San. Back then, I guess, you know, because it was, he's so good at the whole rustic landscape and stuff like that, but I think he's trying too hard to evolve with the times when he probably doesn't need to.
I really just admire his ability to sort of just play for broke, you know, just gamble big.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know, I love that he's not a timid filmmaker.
Yeah. I mean, that's very evident from the scene we just talked about.
Yeah,
because
yeah.
I can name every filmmaker in the industry who wouldn't have even done that scene. Forget going all out and, you know, sort of blowing your trumpets about the scene and romanticizing it to heaven.
Right.
So, I mean, it's good that he went all out there, but it didn't work, you know.
Yeah.
It didn't work because it sort of, the spirit and vision didn't sort of mesh together in one. Maybe if it was another sort of situation, another type of story he was telling, that could just have worked, because it's worked in most of his previous films. I don't know, because I used to be, I mean, I probably still am, but I used to be a big admirer of the way he puts down his stuff, and I just hope to see a film like maybe Black again or something. I can just like, I hope he just comes back into post-19th century, post-20th century. I'd like to see that.
Well, I have to say, I you know, in Bhansali I trust, yeah. And I am sure he will be back.
Same,
bigger and better.
Same here. I just hope a lot of our filmmakers are back after. I mean, you know, we've seen it, no, over the last year. Vishal Bhadwaj, Imtiaz Ali.
Yeah.
But they are filmmakers for a reason, so I guess they will be
They'll
back.
They'll return.
Yeah.
Thank you for watching, and it's me and Rahul Desai signing off. We'll be back next week with more on movies.